Is your iPhone storage almost full? I bet you've seen this message before. Here's how to fix it. We first need to understand what is taking up space locally on the iPhone. So, open up Settings, go to General, and then touch iPhone Storage. At the top, you'll see a visual representation of what's taking up space on this device. Photos is taking up the most space, followed by Applications, Messages, and the operating system. It's important to know that when you get this low on storage, it will prevent you from doing things like software updates or even taking new photos. If we take a step back and go to Software Update, you can see that it is unable to do the iOS 18.2 Beta 2 update. It even tells me at the bottom approximately how much storage is needed to do this update. If I touch Manage Storage, it brings me back to the page we were previously on. Not only can you not do software updates, but if I exit out of the settings and open up the camera to take a photo, it says iPhone storage full. You do not have enough storage to take photos. I can either touch Not Now, which will just get rid of this prompt, or if I touch Manage, it will bring us right back to the settings, showing us the breakdown of what's taking up so much space. Below the visual breakdown above, you may see Apple's recommendations on how to gain space back. I'll touch Show All and see that there are large attachments in Messages, an option for optimized photos, and another option to offload unused apps. If I scroll down farther, you'll see all the installed apps and how much storage they're using. At the very bottom, you'll see the iOS and system data storage. This is storage that can fluctuate and is used by the device and cannot be changed or removed. If you have really high system data storage, it's a good indicator to reboot your iPhone. This will free up some of that space. If I scroll to the top of the application list, I can use the sorting options in the top right to sort by size, name, or last use date. I recommend to sort by size. This makes it easy to see what apps are taking up the most space. As you can see, Photos is taking up over 100 gigabytes on my 128 gigabyte iPhone. If I touch Photos from this list, I see an option to enable optimized photos. If you use iCloud Photos, I would highly recommend this. It is a great option to keep all of your Apple devices on the same page so that you can have access to all of your important memories. If I go back and touch the next app, I can see that GarageBand is taking up almost 2 gigs worth of space. I'll touch that and I'll see two options, offload app and delete app. Offload app will free up space but keep some of the data on the device. I would suggest that if you don't use the app at all, choose delete. You can always re-download the app if you need. So if I go back to the list, I'll touch messages, which is slightly different. I can review large attachments that people have messaged me, or even look at a breakdown of storage used in top conversations, photos, videos, and others. So here's where the magic happens if you use iCloud Photos. I'll go back to the main screen and scroll to the top and touch Enable for Optimized Photos. You'll notice as soon as I do that, the available storage immediately becomes available and the photos start to offload into iCloud. Once I do that, notice you'll be able to go back and do your software updates and take more photos. Thanks for watching. If you want to learn more, be sure to check out the rest of my channel for in-depth videos on more Apple-related topics.